everyone, welcome to the second part of a Lasso Webometrics workshop. Recall that during the first part, we learned how we can hyperlink the entries in our CVs with already existing resources on the web. Today, you shall learn how to digitize the publications that are not already on the web. We shall also learn how we upload and hyperlink the entries of the digitized materials in our CVs. So we are all set for a three-step process. The first is to digitize, the second is to hyperlink, and the third is to upload. So let us begin with step one, which is digitization. Now I can see somebody knocking. I think that's Dr. Akintoye, who wants to be guided on how we can digitize our publications. We'll use that as the example for this
exercise. Good day, sir. Good day, Dr. Akintoye. What can I do for you today?
Thank you, sir. I want you to guide me on how to digitize my publications that are not yet online.
Oh, very nice. Yes, these are the publications of Dr. Akintoye that he has compiled. And of course, he has the book where he has an article, and he has a journal where he has an article, and several others. These ones are not web resources. And what we want to do is to scan these publications and put them online. The first thing, of course, to have is your scanner. Now, this is my scanner, Dr. Akintoye. I'm sure you have a scanner at home, and this is your PC or your my laptop. So these two will have to be connected. With these two equipment, you are good to go. So let us begin, Dr. Akintoye. You have a scanner, it's connected to your computer, and you can see that my scanner, the scanner can be of any model. The one that I have here is HP ScanJet G410. Any of these flatbed scanners can work. Yes. I'm sure you have a good model at home too.
Yes,
I'm sure you do.
Yes,
okay, that's fine.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is connected to the computer, and then you are ready to go. So the first thing that you will do, of course, after you have installed the scanner onto the computer, you are going to have this. What's this icon? HP Scanning G40. Is that all? Ah, fine. So we click on it, and there is the scanner software begins.
Yeah, so let us have a demo of this one very quickly. Dr. Akintoye, you can see that the software is now launched.
Yes.
And you can see the different scan shortcuts, document to TIFF file, document to what?
PDF file.
PDF file, document to searchable PDF file. We want to ask all persons who will be undergoing this training to please select document to searchable PDF file. Regardless of the scanner that you are using, you'll find this as an option. So we want to get to searchable PDF file. We don't want to start scanning immediately. We want to look at some of the settings. So let us go to this change settings. And then we have the scan type. Is this machine here?
Yes, sir.
It's asking us the output. Do you want it in color?
No, sir.
Why don't you want it in color?
Because of the size.
If it's color, the file size will be heavy. So we ask all Lasso persons who are going to be scanning their documents to please select, which one will you select?
Black and white.
Black and white. So this all set. Then it will ask you, where do you want to save the file of this your article? This is a wonderful article. So you go to save to file options. Save to file, save options. When you click on this, it will give you this dialog box. It will ask you, what name do you want to give this your file? So we have a naming scheme, which let me see the naming scheme now. This is it. For your journal articles, we want you to preface it with JA.
Yes.
And this J and A are in lowercase, if you like, small letters. Can you see that? Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
For books, chapters in books, what will we preface it with?
BK, lowercase.
Lowercase. What about proceedings?
PR, lowercase.
Very good. What about conference presentations?
CF.
Very nice. Now, let's go back to your CV. Now, this is your CV. I must congratulate you on the wonderful work. Your CV is very rich, by the way.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
If you go through the CV, we will find that you have some like this. These are publication journal articles right
yes.
here. And these are already on the web.
Yes, sir.
Is this one on the web?
No, sir.
Yeah, this is one of those that we have to digitize and put on the web.
Yes.
What about this?
That is on the web.
No, this one.
It's not.
Because it's not hyperlinked.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you look at this, this is the one we now want to digitize.
Yes, sir.
And put on the web.
Yes, sir.
Today will have been Sunday Banjoku and Akim Akintoye.
Yes, sir.
Express mathematical errors in solving all of that. Great article, I'm sure.
Thank you, sir.
So that's the one we want to. So let's go to how we will name this one. Recall that this is the code.
Yes,
sir. JA for journal articles.
Yes,
sir. Is that one journal article?
Yes, it is, sir.
It's a journal article.
Yes.
So we will put everything now in lowercase.
Okay, sir.
So you have Hakim. Your name is Hakim,
yes,
Akintoye.
Yes,
we have to separate the Hakim and Akintoye with this thing. It's called the under what?
Underscore.
Underscore. This one is what? Underscore.
Underscore.
This one is what?
Underscore.
Now, this one tells us your first name.
Yes,
it bridges, this underscore bridges your first name, like a bridge.
Yes, sir.
And the surname.
Yes, sir.
And this one bridges. What is this one?
The type of
the journal article.
Yes, sir.
And this one, what does the level tell you? That's number
position 11. Of journal article.
Yeah, the numbering of position.
Okay, sir.
The numbering of journal article. Now let's take another quick example. These are chapters in books.
Yes, sir.
If you were digitizing this,
yes,
how will you name it?
I will name it Akim. Akim underscore Akintoye.
Akim. Is it Akintoye or Akintoye?
Akintoye.
Better. Akintoye. Yes.
Underscore
again.
BK.
Why is it BK?
Books.
Okay,
yes,
that's fine.
Yeah, books.
Yes.
Underscore one.
Wonderful. Score 100%, by the way.
Thank you so much.
Very well. Now, let's go to another one. Let's go to articles that have already appeared in conference proceedings. Let's take this number. This one.
Yes.
How will you name it?
Okay.
It will be what?
Akim underscore.
Yes.
Akintoye.
Not Akintoye.
Akintoye.
Don't pronounce your name again.
Akintoye.
Very good. Yes. Uh-huh.
Underscore.
Yes.
PR.
What is it? PR.
Proceedings.
Yes. Proceedings. Very good. PR. Yes.
Underscore one.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So that's actually it. There's a conference presentation, it will be CF, and as you all can see, all of these are in lowercase.
Yes,
your Akim is not capital H.
Yes,
your Akintoye is not capital A.
Yes.
Everything here is what?
They are lowercase.
Lowercase, fine. So let's get back to this dialog box. So, it is that journal article that you want to put in there. So it will be Akim. Just as we say, work on just now. Underscore. Akintoye. Underscore. What?
11.
No.
Journal.
Yeah. No journal now. You got a journal. J-A.
J-A.
Yeah, you forgot something.
Underscore 11.
Wonderful. So that's it. So this file name, this naming, is very important for this exercise, and we must get it right for purpose of revising with you. Is a journal article, the code is JA.
Yes.
If it's a book, it is
BK.
If it's an article published in proceedings, it's PR.
Yeah.
If it's just a conference presentation, CF.
Yes.
So the thing goes like this: you don't allow gaps to be between any of this. The gaps are filled with what?
Underscore.
With this underscore, so it's quite easy. So let's get back to this one. It's asking for where you want to see this file. You can agree to this default, but in one case, I like to let it go to where I can easily locate it. So your best bet is to create a folder or a directory, but if you don't want to go into all of those technical details, you can just accept this. That's where this file will be located. But I want to be able to locate it in a folder in my hard drive, my C drive. You'll see I get to it, 2016. I've called that Lasso scanned documents. So it's here. Then I'll say, okay. What this wonderful thing means is that it's going to scan that your journal article, and it's going to name it this, and it will save it in this location. Yes, and then you say, is that good?
Yes, sir.
Let's say, okay. So we are ready to scan. The next thing to do is to now say scan. And then say okay here. So scanning will begin. You'll be able to hear the sound of the scanning in a minute. So you can see the scanning is coming down.
Yes, sir.
Wonderful. Yeah. Yeah. Very nice. So that's page one. Okay, so we are putting a second.
Okay, fine. So we take this out.
Yes, sir.
You can see we have done the top page. Yes, sir. And then we put this one like this. You can see this is flat enough.
Yes, sir.
If we had been using this your compiled version, it will have, you know, raised the lid of the scanner and give you some black edges. So this is this first page, or this second page. They put it like this, and then dap, and then we're ready to scan again.
Now have, what do you do again? Add pages, very good. So it will start scanning the other page. Very good. What is this, Jonakiti?
Output time.
Black and white, exactly. Yes. That's what you selected as an issue. If yes. We did color, it would be very, very, very heavy. You can see this one page,
yes.
This another page,
yes.
This a third page.
Yes.
So, are there more pages?
Yes.
Okay, fine. One. So, it's the last one. Okay, so we'll take that one on. Okay, so we have scanned the three pages that I can do.
Yes, sir.
Now, this page, what is the size of the file on compress?
The size is 1.1 megabytes.
1.1 megabytes.
Yes, sir.
But just assume, like we talked before, if we're going to put it in color, let's say color. What's the file size now?
27.2 megabytes.
Exactly, 27.2 megabytes. So that's going to make your files so huge.
Okay.
But meantime, you still get the same. Is your copy material is black and white.
Yes.
So we go back here to black and white, and it comes to here. So that's how you do the scanning. It can be 1 million pages. You just go to add pages.
Yes.
Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Now let's come to this page. You can see this page is rather dark.
Yes.
So let me see whether we can do a grayscaling. Yeah. Is it not better?
It's better.
Yeah, we're doing grayscaling, you know, for this one.
Mm-hmm.
And although you can see the file size, it's really huge.
Mm-hmm.
9.1. But maybe we keep it as black and white. It's dark, but it's okay, but it's giving us this size. And
yes,
file size is important in the material that you want to upload. Something else you must know. This one, can you read what is written there? Crop.
Yes, sir.
That means define a portion of the image that you want to. So if I click on crop, it will then give me you give me this handles. You can move this here. Yeah, I think we can do that so that it keeps all of these ones off.
Mm.
So it becomes smaller. The dark area, you know, is now smaller. Let's look at this one. Do we want to crop anything here? Let's see. It's really the image. I think this is okay.
It's okay, sir.
Okay.
It's
okay. What about the third page? What about this page?
It's also okay.
It's also okay.
Yes.
Fine. So all we need to do, what is this? Finish. It's a finish. So you can see finishing the scan to computer, scan images will send to this. So you send the images to this location where I said they should be. So just wait for it. It's scanning this third one now. It's taking this one, taking this one, taking this one. And then it will tell you that it's all done. So it's processing the page to that location, processing page two. So it's not taking them now as single files. It's taking them all together as one file, which we have named this. This Akito is something that we have named the thing. So that's how this runs. So when done, now come back with this dialog box asking you, Dr. Akito, do you want to scan some more? You say yes. Then you then take another journal article and your process goes the same sequence. Okay, Dr. Akito, are you happy with what we have done so far?
Very happy, sir.
Very good, yes.
Sir, is it possible for me to see what the documents we scanned?
Oh, yes, of course. Now, recall that I saved this thing in a folder called Lasso, where you Lasso scanned documents, yes, which is this.
Yes,
so you can see it, Akito, JA11.
Yes, sir.
The system has added all of these ones to it.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to tell you what you're going to do with all this 0001 thing.
Yes, sir.
So, but let's click on it and let's see. Yeah, so you can see. Yes. This is the cover. You recall that I cropped off the bottom part of it.
Yes,
all those black areas.
Yes.
And then let's look at page 2. Does not look nice?
Very nice, sir.
Looks nice. Page 3 also looks very nice. So that's how it is, the output, the final output. Yeah, okay. So back to this name. Can you read this name?
Akintoye_GE_11001.
Okay, fine. Did you put this 0001 there?
No, sir.
Where did you stop it?
At 11. At
11. Okay,
yes,
so what we all must do is to chop up this 0001.
Okay, sir.
And how will you do that? Do you know?
By double-clicking.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, right-clicking.
Okay.
And asking it to, let's see, name. Let me see whether we have... so what you do, you look at this here, and you right-click on it. Can you see rename here?
Yes, sir.
If you say rename, what do you want to do to this file? You want to just chop up this 0001 and keep it like that?
Yes, sir.
Is that it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is how I want it to be. Yes, so you are like half done with this work.
Yes, sir.
Recall that we agreed to hyperlink it. Now we have not hyperlinked it. Look at your CV. This is your CV.
Yes, sir.
All these are hyperlinked with resources that are already online.
Yes, sir.
This is this one that is not hyperlinked.
Yes, sir.
Now, so we want to hyperlink this. When you were hyperlinking, what did you do that time? You right-clicked.
Yes.
And you said hyperlink. Let me see. We're right-clicking this. Oh, excuse me. You right-click. Excuse me. You highlight it.
Yes, sir.
This is what we want to hyperlink. So let me right click on it. You can you see hyperlink?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this hyperlink. Now what? Yeah, you see it. Okay, fine.
You
so
need to go to
the web.
Exactly.
No, you don't need to go to the web, but we are still going to transfer this scan file to the web.
Okay.
Yeah. So what we'll do, and I like all our viewers to listen to this very carefully. You click on hyperlink.
Yes.
Is that asking you for the address to which issue put this hyperlink? Now we have the Lasso website. We are transferring this whole thing to the Lasso website, and we have created a folder, or if you like, a directory where we are going to pour in all of these materials. So what you will do is I think I need to pause to now go back to the naming system. Yeah, so how do we then hyperlink this to the resource that we have just digitized? Like you did for this, you know, for this one, you highlighted it.
Yes.
And then you press the right button of the mouse to show hyperlink. So the same thing. So you highlight this is a document we just scanned. and then you right click on it,
yes,
and it comes up with the same dialog box which has hyperlink here.
Yes, sir.
So you click on hyperlink. It's telling us where is the address that you want to hyperlink this. Please record, we are going to do this twice because it's another very crucial aspect of the work. It's asking for the address. Were it to be a resource that's already present on the web, you know, you just go there and they right click and it gives you the address and you paste here.
Yes.
But we don't know what this address is. So what we have done is to prepare, let me see now, to prepare a template for that address. And this template is what we have here. Yeah, so this is the template, this one here. What is this one telling us? This one is telling us that this is the Lasso website, lasso.edu.ng. We have a folder created called Publications for Everybody. And then, depending on the faculty, we have now created a subdirectory, or if you like, a folder. Akito is in education, so what do we have? We have this Lasso website, publications, and then education. So all Lasso staff will have this, and the only difference among faculties will be this. So for education staff, it will be education. For agriculture, this will be replaced with agriculture. For medicine, it will be replaced with medicine. As you can see, all the renderings here are in small letters, or if you like, lowercase. Of course, don't worry about this being in red, just to show the difference between the faculties and so. If you are in law, it will be law. It will be social sciences. We are bundling this together because we don't want a space between social and sciences. So it will be social sciences here. If you are in transport, it will be transport, you know. So you will see this these codes in a little while. So let's return this to education because that is where Akito is. And then the article that we scanned just now is Akito. Okay, it was a journal article, and that's 11, so JA 11. That's the journal article that we scanned. Recall that we scanned it as a PDF file, a portable, in a portable document format. This is just a format. It can be Word, it can be with the DOC, that's doc, or DOCX, and so on. But we have saved this as a PDF file, and you must put this PDF at the end of the naming. In an event that you make any mistake here whatsoever, then you are going to have an error message pop up at you. So this is a very important line in the addressing. So what are we going to do now? We want to hyperlink this to Akitoye's entry in the CV. So we highlight this, you right click, and then we copy. After copying, we go to Akitoye's CV. So this is the entry. So we highlight this, just like we did for the first one that are on the web. You right click this, you go to hyperlink, wonderful, and it's asking for the address. You now paste this, you right click this this area, and they say paste. So that is it. You can see it very nicely. You can see http://lasso.edu.ng publications. That's where everybody's publications will be dumped or put. Education is the faculty, and this is the file name. Don't forget, PDF will have to be there. And they say okay. So this is now hyperlink. You can see the blue color and the other line has now come up. Now let us even test this. Let's test. You cannot test because you will not have uploaded your file at the time you have hyperlinked, but we are going to test it for you at the back end. So let's test this. Testing, you can say control plus click. I'm going to do just that. And let us see, because we have uploaded this particular file, let's see what happens to it at the, yes, go ahead, at the Lasso website end. Wonderful. So you can see it's loading it. Loading 773, you know, it's about 3.3 meg. You can actually see the address here, lasso.edu.ng publications education / archive. If you paste the file address here when it has been uploaded, you can easily get the file coming up. So let's continue while this is uploading. I'm sorry, why it is downloading. You know, we uploaded it, this upload download thing. It's now downloaded. It's downloaded about 2/3 of it. We're almost there. So you can see 3.17, 3.20, 3.30. Wow. So here we come. This Akito is file that you uploaded. You can see the address. You can see it there. It's there. So it's as easy as that. It's, you can scroll down. This is page 3. This is page 2. And this is page 1. How wonderful. So one thing that we all know is that this is constant for all. In other words, if you are hyperlinking, this must appear in all. I'm copying this now. I just copy this. And if you get your CV, and you, what's that? Yes. Well, if this to be the entry that he wants to hyperlink, if you right click, I go to hyperlink and you paste this. So all our entries or addresses must have this, regardless of the faculty that we're in. So if you are in science, for instance, in the science, excuse me. / your name. Let me put the name of Professor Damola. Okay, who is the wonderful dean? Who was wonderful dean of science? So it will be Damola _. Okay, _. Let's assume it's a journal article. JA _. 12. That is entry number 12. .edf. So that will be it. So it's now hyperlinked. If I click on this, nothing is going to happen because we have not uploaded a file by that name. That's just to give you a sense of how this thing works. So let us summarize what we have done so far. First thing you do is to connect your scanner to the computer. And then from the computer, you launch the scanner software. And for every of the publications, you scan all the pages and save them into a single file. So each publication, one single file with all the pages. In other words, if you have 60 publications, how many different files should you have? 60, of course. Now, these are some very important things that we should recall as we summarize. You should use these codes for the different types of publications. Recall that we use this where we were doing the practice with Dr. Akintoye. JA for journal articles, BK for books, chapters in books, PR for proceedings, and CF for conference presentations. So to name, you put your first name, you put an _, you put your last name, an _, and then the type of publications, and then the number as it appears listed in your CV for journal article, for books, for proceedings. Also very important is this. when you are hyperlinking, this is a standard for every Lasso staff. This is our website, and then we have created a folder where we go to pour all the publications for everybody. But even within this house of publications, we have put in some different rooms. As you see here, publications for education people, they're going to be here. And then you have your file name. Another very important thing for you to note is that these are the small rooms that were put in the publications house. Remember, publications house, this one, this publications house for each of the faculties. So for agriculture, you are going to have agriculture, arts, communication, education, engineering, law, management, medicine, science, social sciences, transport, in alphabetical order. Recall that there is no capital letter anywhere. All of these are in lowercase. So what are the next steps? We expect that you submit a flash drive which contains your hyperlink CV and all the scanned publications. In other words, if you have 60 publications, you are going to have 60 files. And then your hyperlink CV will make the 61st file, that's 61 files in total. Put all of this in a flash drive and submit to the Director of Academic Planning. But we want you to email only the hyperlink CV, that is the CV that has been hyperlinked to the resources that you scanned, to three of us. This is me, this is Ahmed Usani, and this is the Director of Academic Planning. We intend to upload all these materials. The webmaster of Lasso, a great person, will do that. And then we'll return the flash drive to you. I'd like to thank Aiko Aziz of the Lasso Multimedia Center for recording the initial part of the videos to this session. And from me, Tao Kebukola, it is bye for now.